Hey people, welcome to Dots and Moms. My name is Kavita and in today's video we are talking on how to take care of nipples during pregnancy and while breastfeeding. Breastfeeding is an awesome journey, and to keep it happier for us as well along with the child, it is important that we take care of certain things. We are ensuring that our nipple health is taken care of, and we prevent situations like cracked nipples, sore nipples, then nothing like it. And in case we have knowledge on how to take care of situations like that, it is amazing as well, right? So in this video, we will talk about all these in detail. So please consider watching the video till the end. Now we are talking about pregnancy nipple care. Most of them have these issues post-delivery, that on the first day when it is very important, the crucial milk we are not able to give to our child because of soreness or cracked nipples, dryness in the nipples, or inverted nipples. To ensure that these issues are not there during pregnancy, after 5-6 months you can start massaging your nipples by using 2-3 drops of natural oil like coconut oil or groundnut oil, and just rub it around the area and lightly massage and pull your nipples out, okay? And by this way you can ensure that the nipple health is good and fantastic. And also remember, you do not have to overdo this on a regular basis. Daily 2 times if you do this, it's great. Anything more than that, that too especially while you are nearing your due date, may trigger delivery. So reduce the amount while you are nearing delivery, but ensure to continue doing this because it is very important that you have a safe and healthy breastfeeding journey. Post-delivery nipple care tips. At first, one must ensure that the baby is latching well, sucking properly, and the areola, the black part of our breast, is completely inside baby's mouth, and we will definitely have no issues. The sucking is fine, baby is getting the milk properly. Otherwise, it will only be sucking at the tip and it will hurt you more, and even the baby would not be getting the milk sufficiently. So we are talking about certain things which are myths as well. At first, it is mostly at all the houses, it is recommended that you wipe your breast before and after feed, or wipe using tissues, wet tissues, or wiping using wet cloth. Wet cloth is to an extent okay, but definitely do not use any wipes. Any chemical can really be causing issues to your child. It is not necessary because the bacteria around your nipples are really going to be healthy for your baby's gut microbiome. So never overdo it. It is not necessary at all at first place. Second thing, on your areola, you can find some little black bumps, and these are Montgomery glands which produce oil, and this is to naturally protect you from bacteria and infection. And this natural oil, which is necessary, natural lubricative, is really healthy to keep your nipples soft, supple, and ensuring that there are no cracks happening. So while taking bath, do not rub it thinking that your baby would keep sucking your nipples, and you have to keep your breast and area around neat. So please do not rub it with too much of soap. You need that, and just washing it with warm water would be really enough. Next, ensure that you use cotton clothes only, because it is important that you your nipples are dry. So wear cotton nursing bras, cotton maternity clothes as much as possible. Nursing pads are boon for working moms because these protect us from spoiling the outer layer of the clothes that we are wearing. Now, milk letdown is a common thing, especially when you are out and you do not feed your baby on time. You do not want that mark on your clothes. So nursing pads come handy. These are cheap as well, not very expensive. And when you are at home, you can use cotton clothes as well. Folding some cotton clothes and using is fine. But when you are out, ensure that you change it frequently. Otherwise, you know the sweetness of the milk, the warmth nature of it, and that being filled with milk itself can be a place of bacteria and yeast breeding there. So please ensure that you change it frequently. And another tip is that every time after you feed your baby, take 2 drops of breast milk and rub it around your nipple, and this way you will ensure that your nipple is always protected and soft and supple. So this also ensures that you have lesser cracked nipple issues. Even further, in case you have any issues, you can try this and it will be helpful. Avoid using any sort of commercial nipple cream, because while breastfeeding, every time you'll have to clean it, and those chemicals are really not needed. But if you have sore nipples or cracked nipples and the issue is too much, I would advise you to use nipple shields. These are protection for your nipples, and to an extent it will reduce the pain compared to direct feeding. So once you are okay, you can feed directly. But if it is increasing, the pain is more, you are still bleeding, at first it is advisable that you take a break of 24 hours or 48 hours, that is 1 day or 2 days, and let it dry, because while sucking, if the baby is not sucking well, then again you will face problem. You will have to express milk, otherwise you will feel much higher pain. But if you are still in pain, you are having fever because of that, please consult doctor and only then take the medication, because painkillers or antibiotics just like that over the counter, mothers should never take. Maintaining good hygiene is also important. Not just the cloths we wear, the things we use like breast pump or nipple shield, those have to be sterilized each time. Now, sterilizing is a very simple process. You don't need any bigger machines for sterilization. Hot boiling water, put these accessories inside it and boil it for 5 minutes and take it out. This is just that sterilization which is needed. Last but very important thing, you must understand that if you are regularly getting a sore nipple issue or cracked nipple issue, it is because your baby is not latching well. So please meet a lactation consultant. They will be able to guide you the proper way, and they'll be able to understand and see what is going wrong. See, most of them say, why do I need a lactation consultant when I already have the best gynec here? See, I'll just give you a simple example. You go for construction, then you are meeting an architect. Architect would assign certain jobs to plumber, electrician and carpenter, and they only know in-depth knowledge about it, and the architect knows only majorly that this has to come here, this has to come there, but in-depth how the wiring needs to be done and other things, electrician only knows. So that's the role of lactation consultant. They study in-depth about lactation and things need to be done to correct it, etc., etc. So they are the right people who can help you. So it is necessary and important that we meet them. Maybe we will be shelling out little extra money, but this boon of breast milk is something really needed for your child, at least until a year. And if a little help can help you provide that to your child, why not, right? And do not give up on it very easily. Breast milk is magically needed for your child. But if not, if you tried everything and then you are not able to, then definitely formula milk is there as a savior. So I really hope that the points that I have included in this video will help you. And I have made a video on 12 natural tips on how to increase breast milk. Please watch that. There's a video on how to introduce solids, how, when, and methods of introducing solids to babies. Check this video as well. And as the brand name says, Tots and Moms, I run an organic food store by the same name. That's the one thing that first started, and then the YouTube channel as a support to our customers who had a lot of queries. So at this food store, we sell porridge mixes, cereal, instant mixes. We also sell dry fruit powder, ragi powder, and you can find cookies, pancake mixes, drink mixes for growing up children. Everything made of jaggery and All our products are USDA certified organic, and we have very good reviews on Amazon, Flipkart, FirstCry, Meesho, Big Basket. Do check them. And thank you so much for watching this video again. I really hope that you would follow, click on that subscribe button so that you get updates of all the future videos that I make. See you soon. Bye-bye.